Welcome back to our channel. For this course, you need your skirt block, and already I have mine. You can draw as many lines as you want on the side. The lines are on the side. So I'm going to cut through. I'm not cutting out. I'm going to cut through in order to spread and slash my pattern, in order for me to have more fullness on the side for the cowl. This is a one of our subscribers request. He has us to show her how to sew, so I believe so many of us also want to know how to stitch a cowl skirt, so that is why we have this on. So now that I have it, you can see I didn't cut it out, I cut through on. So I'm going to place the side together in this direction, but I'll need my thumb pin to hold it down. You can as well use your nylon tape to hold down. So I'm going to pin down quickly. You pin down by putting the side together. You ensure the side are together in this format, so that, you know, I am using a small scale. You can have as many lines as you want. This is an illustration. As many lines as you want, so you can gather more fullness for the cowl. So you pin down, you ensure you place properly, you pin down in this direction, you open it up. You can measure the amount of fullness you want, though it's not compulsory like me. You can. Anyway, as I was saying, you need your skirt block pattern to do this, and what we are working on is the side, the center front and the center back. You can see the back each other. It is a side we put together to achieve this. And at the end of the day, by the time you finish stitching, if you want it as a skirt, you can use it as a skirt, which means the center back will be opened for zipper to go in and band. And if you have a more fullness and you increase the waist, probably you want to put elastic band, you can increase the waist to insert your elastic band, which means the center back will be closed. So still pinning down my pattern. So I'm done with it now. So I'm going to retrace. I'm going to trace all the pattern. I'm going to trace out now. What am I tracing? I'm going to connect. First of all, I'm going to connect the side that the part. Yeah, you can see that I opened up, you know, for me to have that fullness. So I'm going to close the side, because that is where we'll be stitching. We'll be stitching. I'm going to close there. I'm ruling the line so we know where to stitch. Then I'll reshape the waistline for me to have a definite waistline. Then my center front, you can see waist. Then rule out my center front. Then the hem, I'm going to mark it out, which I'm going to reshape as well to blend, because we can't have our skirt in this direction. We are going to shape the hem as well. So I'm reshaping the waist, and this is the side. So next thing I'm going to do, you can see the center back, though I didn't add seam or anything to it. So this is what it's going to look like. I'm taking out my pin and the pattern, so you can see what it looked like before adding my seam allowance and reshaping. It is very simple. When you're using a bisque, you will understand more better. So I'm reshaping the hem because we can't leave it like that. You need to reshape it. It needs to be curved so your skirt will sit properly on you. Now you're going to add a seam allowance. I wrote unfold there. That is, it means it's not going to be cut out if your fabric is enough, if your fabric, if you place in such a way that the center front and center back is not going to be in pieces, fine. But if your fabric is not enough, like mine, which I used, is not enough, you want to manage your fabric, it means you're going to stitch both the center front and the center back. But remember, if you're adding elastic, you don't need a center back to be open, but if it's a zipper, you need a center back to be open. So I added a seam allowance 1 centimeter each to the waist and to the side, and also to the hem. You can add more if you want for your own, for you to, it depends on how convenient you are with seam. I am very convenient with 1 centimeter. So now I'm going to cut out, cut this out so I can place on my fabric to get the job done. Ensure you do this properly. It's very easy to work on paper. I'm not saying draping or directly on fabric is not good. Welcome back. Now I have it placed on my fabric. Like I said, the fabric is not enough, so I can't place on food and like that. So I'm cutting out on the fabric. So I had a little seam to the back and to the front because the center, because the fabric is not enough for me to cut the back and the front to place on fold. So I had little seam to it, which I'm going to use to close those areas. So I have it cut out. So what I'm going to do now, I've stitched the center front and the center back, but I left the center front, the center back a little bit open for zipper. So you pick the side together. You can see what I did. Pick the sides together. Stitch. Yes, you stitch that. You pick the side, that is the waist together, but the side is what you're stitching. Can you see? You stitch the 1 inch or your seam allowance. So I have it stitched. This is my waistline. You can see the waistline. This is the side, and the other side. That's the side too. That's the side. So let's see what it looks like. It's very, very simple. So that's the waistline. Of course, because I'm using a small scale, you might not really see the effect, but I would need you to try it on a small scale for you to understand properly before you now go ahead on your fabric. Thank you for watching. Please give this video a like, share, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, and also tell us what you want us to do. So what do you want us to do? So I have my center back opened a little bit for zipper. So this is what's going to look like, but you will have more fold than what I have. Thank you. Stay tuned, we have more for you. Thank you.